Hi, I'm Michael Forrest and I run squares.tv. And I have noticed recently that when I produce a live stream with Ecamm, I'm often acting as a broadcast showrunner with no technical team. I'm always worrying about framing and audio levels and juggling all my different scenes, but that can make it difficult to be present and really listen to what my guests are saying. Or I can just look a bit distracted when I'm on camera, just looking to the side. And I know I'm not the only one. I recently spoke to Tony Fow, who's an award-winning broadcast professional, about his experiences running a live panel show, and he talked about all of those complications. But one of the things that he talked about was the value of a cue sheet or a beat sheet, planning a list of segments that you'll step through to keep everything nice and professional. This actually inspired me to build a tool called Beat Sheet, which is designed to make show running a little easier, and it helps you plan more professional live streams. But structure is an art to itself, and if you want some help with that, I recently recorded this interview with Olu Sibanjo, who has a formula for this kind of thing. So she talks about hook, intro, story, three bullet points, have a summary and then a call to action, and run your live streams in a way that is going to be optimized for then uploading to YouTube. But that's on a podcast, Can You See My Screen, which you can find in the notes somewhere. But let me show you how to plan a stream with Beat Sheet, because I'm using it right now. So this is Beat Sheet here. So I have Ecamm running and I have Beat Sheet here. This basically works with documents. So we can just go File New to create a new broadcast, basically. Let's plan what we're going to do. So I think in our case, well, another way of looking at what Olu talks about is just tell them what you're going to tell them, then tell them, and then tell them what you told them. So I'll start by just adding an introduction. Live typing. Tell what you're gonna tell them, right? And then we can add another segment with the button up here or command enter. And that's gonna be tell them. And then let's just sort of reference some of my scenes here. And we'll say, maybe I wanted to introduce Tony. Olu, and then maybe a summary, and then maybe a call to action, right? And then, but maybe we want to start with a blank screen, so let's put a blank screen in first for when we hit record, and maybe we want a title sequence as well, so I'm just going to put titles in there. So this is going to be, so we'll do our intro, and then, yeah, maybe we'll have an intro first. So that's how you set up your document, and then you can put as much as you like in here. It'll grow big, it'll grow small. You can do what you want. You can sort of use even sort of screenwriting, you know, screenwriting structure. So I've got MF. Hello, I'm Michael. So you can do anything you want with it. Really, it's just text. You can put emojis in there. But the other thing you can do with this is you can control Ecamm. So my blank screen is one. My introduction, I'm going to go to my main scene. Now, you can type hotkeys here, but I found myself very confused by this because by default, with no hotkeys assigned in Ecamm, you'll get this 1 to 7 assigned. So what I'm going to do here is just use the default ones because it gets weird otherwise. So we're going to go default scene, and then our titles are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Let's go to command 7, and then we'll come back to 2. And then when we introduce Tony, we'll go to 3. And then Olu is 4. And then our summary, we'll come back to 2. And then call to action is, I think, 6. And then this gives us a, sorry about that, I have noise. We can just run this by pressing play button. So start show, fades to black. And here we go, introduction, tell him what you're going to tell him. And so that's gone to scene 2. We go forward, we get a nice... So we got a nice little title sequence there. And then we can sort of have one video appear, and then we can come forward and we can have the next video appear, come back to the summary, and then come to our call to action, which is squares.tv/beatsheet. So I'm just going to come back the main view and say, yeah, so we talked about the value of a cue sheet for running a professional broadcast, and I just showed you how to use the app that I've released called BeatSheet, which you can get right now. And it's very simple for now, but I've got big plans for it. And for example, I shouldn't tell you this, but I actually have it Bluetooth connected to a companion app on my phone, which is giving me a teleprompter, which is how I'm able to make eye contact. But that's coming in version 0.2. For now, you get this thing that can help you control your stream. But if you want any more information, you can just come to squares.tv/beatsheet. And just, you know, dig in, get involved, have a look at the other stuff on there. I'm working hard. I'm doing this. You know, I have my Shoot Clean, well, it used to be Shoot Clean camera feed. It's now called Shoot Pro Webcam. So I've got a camera app you can use, and I have this, and I have a delay calculator and other various things. But just start with squares.tv/beatsheet, and I will hopefully see you there. Cheers.